面对啊。 面对啊。 here.
What do you mean?
Those things. Ah, those things. Long story short, Mike Buddy started a company called Lightspeed Grip and Lighting Company, which, yes, is a Star Wars reference. He just recently, the bastard, he recently got to interview at least Harrison Ford. I don't know if he interviewed other members of the Star Wars cast, but he just sent me a picture last night that was him, like, smiling next to Harrison Ford, and I'm like, oh, yeah. Okay, Ewok. I'm Wicket. What's up, Wicket? Could you help me out? Tebow and Poplu are too busy with important stuff. I want to get some of the big drums together, but I'm too small to carry them. I'll show you a trick when you get them. Okay.
Let's get this over with.
Warwick Davis teaching me tricks. Nicole Z got to jump on that. Yeah, I don't know if Nicole Z is going to come over to our house. But, I don't know. You never know. Saw Nicole Z, I think, at PSX this weekend, but there were so many people. I think I like saw her and was like, oh, Nicole Z, when I'm done with this conversation, I'll go over and say hi. And then, like, you look over and gone. Too many people to say hi to. Oh, Wicket. Oh, Wicket, you're adorable. Oh, Wicket. The cuteness is intense right now. Nice. As much as I love Han, I'm gonna switch stuff out, and I'm gonna do something we actually haven't done with Rise of the Empire yet, which is we got costume discs. So, I think I put this on, like, once, but I haven't spent a lot of time playing as Luke Skywalker in his X-Wing pilot outfit, which again, you know, will prep you for the Episode 7 hype. I was at PSX and, you know, of course stopped by the Disney Infinity booth, and they had behind plastic. They were not playable at PSX, which is kind of crazy, actually. I don't know why they weren't showing that off, but they had Kylo Ren and Poe Dameron and... Dameron or Dameron? Dameron probably makes more sense. What's up, Paplu? Speeder bikes are so pretty. I've watched them since the Skull ones arrived. Could you show me what they can do? I want to see properly how fast they can go. Luke is your man. Hey, what's up, guys? Okay, what are we doing? Alright, let's do it. I think I start clocking me when I go in. Okay, nice. Yeah, they had the new figures there. But, Luke, you know, kind of reminiscent of Poe with his X-Wing outfit on. I'm actually kind of curious to compare the old X-Wing outfits to the new X-Wing outfits. I wonder if there's, like, subtle differences between the two designs. But, you know, Episode 7 comes out in a week, a week from tomorrow, a week from two days from now, a week from Thursday, and which hopefully means I will be getting the figures soon. It'd be really great if I could have them on Toybox Tuesday next week. If I get them and it's not Tuesday, oh geez, I will. If there's too many cool games to stream on our usual streaming schedule, I'll pop in sometime and get on there, because I definitely want to play with those figures before that movie comes out. I don't know if I'll really get into the playset. I'm curious what the embargo is going to be for the Force Awakens playset. If they're going to place the embargo before the movie comes out. Because I kind of want to see the movie and then play that playset. I admittedly, sadly, have not been doing isolated reviews of the individual playsets, which I would love to do, but there's just too many things to review right now. We will see. We'll see what the embargo will be for that. I don't know. Luke, you missed one. For reference, Wicket, this is not how fast they can go. Luke missed one. What are you gonna do? Oh no, oh no, no, go back. This is terrible. Come on, Luke. Maybe I should have picked Han. Maybe Han's a better pilot. Oh. Nice. I think I played this at Comic-Con. I think when I, there we go. They weren't really tracking my time. They're like, just finish the race. If you play the playset on the stream before the movie, I am not watching, that's for sure. Okay, I probably won't. We'll save it for later. Maybe I'll wait, like, the Tuesday after that. And hopefully, you know, fair warning, get out there and see Episode 7. But from the trailer, It looks like they're staying away from spoilers. It looks like it'll just be kind of like a fun celebration of, you know, most stuff that we've seen already in the trailers. I mean, if you can kind of glean, like, the order of the events if you watch some of the trailers, but how do those toys influence the game? Well, they get their own playset, which is cool. A lot of times, figures are added to Disney Infinity that don't get their own playset. Case in point, all of these Star Wars Rebels characters. There was no Star Wars Rebels playset. Looks like I probably gotta go up. Is this an elevator? Can I take that up? There we go. What's up, Ewok? What do you got? I'm Tebow, lead warrior of Bright Tree Village. Is it called Bright Tree? I never knew that. Lando has tasked me with sending a spy to the camp of the Skull Ones. You must help me disguise the Ewok spies and then catapult them into the camp. All right. Select a stormtrooper disguise for the Ewok. Oh, where do I do that? Okay. I'm guessing you'll be like this playset and hit the main story beats. Yeah. But I just think, you know, people are so familiar with this story that they kind of want to see those moments recreated where, like, not so much. Look at the star map. Can you really go to other places from there? Yeah. There's skulls all over the place. Where am I going? What am I missing here? Oh, do I? Okay, wait. I guess I grab one of these guys. Yeah, you, get over here. Grab this guy. Chuck him into there. Oh, man. Oh, that's too much. Little stormtrooper Ewok. Oh, that's so awesome. Okay. Oh, that's so good. Okay. Episode 7 can't possibly meet the hype because the hype already went out of control a while ago. We'll see. We will definitely see. I've been trying to keep my hype in check. It's tricky, hype's tricky because it's like, what are you really hyped for? Like, what do you want Episode 7 to be? And I think that's one reason why, like, my hype might be tempered for Episode 7, because it's like, I don't necessarily need the Star Wars story to go in any direction, you know? Like, I don't want Luke, Han, or Leia to die. That would be unfortunate, but, you know, if they want to move the story forward, and, you know, these guys have certainly gotten enough screen time in film. Nice. I don't know what that Ewok's gonna do once he's in there. Hopefully he survives that fall. It's a Minox. Oh, wait.
Hey!
Nice. Let's get these Minox. Oh, I need that Boba Fett figure so bad. Okay. The hype has no voice at all. Yeah, Huber's voice is gone. Ewok sounds like an electronic Chinese cooking implement. Could be. Alright, we got quests all over the place. I don't want to sit next to Huber when watching Episode 7. Yeah, I'm speaking of Mike Buddy, who I was talking about earlier, I will be going to see Episode 7 with him, so. I will be with my nearest and dearest. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. I got a bad feeling about Han in Episode 7. Whammy, so do I. I got, you know, I know there's a shot in one of the trailers. I'm like, oh no. I hope that's not what I think it is. You still haven't had lunch with JV to get your Boba Fett figure, Brandon? Nope, all sorts of Boba Fett promises have been made. But I'll get it next month, so. Our scouts have reported a Skull One hunting party is heading toward us. Oh no. We have to catapult weapons around the forest, use those to destroy enemies, protect the village. You got it, dude. I am on it. I think. Am I headed in the right direction? Nope. Here we go. I think I'm going back to the thing I was just at. Yep. Gotta slide around the Ewok village. Episode 7, sponsored by Bud Light. Level up with Han Solo. I want to let you guys know, as the editor-in-chief of GameTrailers.com, I strongly encourage you guys to make fun of Kyle Bossman and Bud Light whenever possible. Okay, these catapults are fun, but I got a lightsaber. Like, I would just rather, you know, go down there and just lightsaber these guys. Not to mention my aim is apparently atrocious. Yeah, if you guys could conveniently stand right there, that'd be great. explosions don't have a heck of a lot of spread to them. There we go. Skullheads is interesting. I wonder if that was ever in, like, the novels or comic books, or if that's something that Disney came up with. Because we never get, like, Ewok subtitles. We just kind of hear, like, you know, C-3PO, like, loosely translates for him. Which is interesting. I never thought about that. Like, when Jabba talks, we get subtitles. When Greedo talks, we get subtitles. But, like, the Ewok language is kind of ambiguous. They don't really, like, tell you specifically what the Ewoks are saying. Like, we don't get subtitles for R2-D2, even though he's, like, clearly saying stuff. I didn't deserve 3 stars for that. Don't get... No, that's terrible. I like the new light-up lightsaber. I love... Oh, Arlos. Yeah, I haven't gotten those yet. For those of you guys who don't know, they have re-released the Jedi characters. So you got Yoda, Vader, you know, Obi-Wan, Ahsoka, you got the Rebels characters who I always forget. You got Anakin, and all of their lightsabers light up now when you put them on the base. If you know me, and you know me in Infinity Figures, I don't like doubling down on characters unless it's like Hulkbuster, like a clear major difference between that character. But if it's just a character, like, well, I mean, Hulkbuster's kind of riding the line because it is him, like, in a different outfit. But I don't like repeating characters. And certainly if like the lightsaber is like the only thing that changes, like, I'm good. I don't need that. I'm not, you know, like, if they send me those, fantastic. I will accept them, but like, I don't need to run out to the store and get those. But if you guys don't own Infinity and you guys are just picking it up for the holidays, you know, get the, you know, make sure to see if you can get the ones where they light up, because that's pretty cool. And they said, like, they didn't release that when it launched because they had the idea. They're like, we want to do that, but they just didn't have the time. What a cute little AT-ST. It's adorable. Whoa, Luke's gotta level up some more. Hold on a second. Yeah, I was waiting to buy some characters that light up. Nice. So Luke's got 7 more points. Air assault. Yeah, sure. Wait a minute, wait, what are you? Luke pushes surrounding objects into the air, holding them while momentarily before firing each one. Hold at the end of a combo when an opponent is hit. Increase the recharging rate of force finisher. Yeah. Oh wait, that'll be 6. Oh yeah, health, sure. Powerful attack that damages all nearby enemies. 5. Okay, I need to find one that's 4. Skywalker's defense. No. Hold on a second. It's tricky because I don't want to, like, have any points left behind. 4, there we go. Okay, yeah, we'll do air juggle. There we go. Alright, we have spent all of Luke's points. Whew. Bye, Whammy. Thank you for coming in. Oh, wait. Hold on. Oh, they're teaching us how to use it. Hold on. Let's... No, I was jumping. Hold on. Okay. Nice. Cool. Alright, where's that... Oh, that one guy walked by me. Where's he going? Get over here. Oh, bye, hun. My wife took off, too. I miss my wife when she comes into chat. I miss her when she goes out of chat. Need to pay more attention. I don't have a co-pilot here. I don't have a Chewbacca for my Toybox streams, so... Oh, do I have to... I can't just, like, hop in this guy? I gotta damage him first? Don't mind me. Oh, nice. You got the... Okay. Whoa! Oh, nice! Look at that! I almost got him! With a little trap. That's cool. Let me see if I can get him with the trap. Hey, get over here. Come get some. Oh, he's stuck by the thing that I operate the trap. Okay, fine. Oh, nice, I got him! Yeah! Can I hop in now? Whoops. I guess that's not how that works. Arlos resubbed for 13 months in a row. Arlos... That is the perfect time to resub during Toybox Tuesday for Arlos. Thank you, man. How do I take this guy over? Maybe I gotta get on top. Helps have a force character with a force jump. Nope. I seem to be falling through this guy. I don't know if this is how you do it. Arlos, I need your help. How do I do this? I was not paying attention when the Ewok spoke to me. Okay. I mean, you know who's no stranger to taking over AT-STs? Mr. Chewbacca here. Maybe I need Chewbacca. Alright, Chewie, let's do it. No. Let's scratch that. wonder who else we got? Oh, Leia. Oh, and Leia's got her Bausch outfit, as long as we're in Return of the Jedi mode. Oh, when it gets low, it does something. All right, thanks, Arlos. Appreciate it. Yeah. So cool. All right. Oh, nice. Okay, there we go. Did it. Excellent. Oh, I like that you can see him. Don't call me Chicken Walker. Alright, let's go beat up some troops. Yeah, the proportions are, like, intentionally cartoony. In Infinity, that is true. I mean, case in point, this AT-ST that I'm in, you know, like, it's definitely... It's just a cute little AT-ST. Whereas, like, you play Battlefront, and, like, those are a little intimidating. Lots of Fallout 4 chat happening. I cannot chime in on Fallout 4, I have not played it yet. Nice. Leia giggling. Alright, let's park that right there. Good job, Leia. See, now available in the toy box. Nice. Alright. Alright. Leia is a very accomplished speeder bike rider. I would say Leia's better on a speeder bike than Luke is. Because Luke, like, bails at some point. Where are we going? Lando's got no more quests. We got a couple exclamation points there. I think we got an elevator here. Oh no, we can just... Have you guys seen that Final Fantasy VI is on Steam? No, I have not seen that. That's fascinating. I wonder what the load times are like. Double, double. Okay. We really want the yellow ones, if we want to try to get to the last chapter. Which I don't know what that would be, actually. Death Star, probably. You must release this individual and return them. Okay. I will do it. Take the soldier back to Chief Chirpa. I will say that the quests so far in the Rise Against the Empire playset are a little more... They make a little bit more sense than the quests that are in the Twilight of the Republic playset. Like, some of those... It's weird, because Rise of the Republic is clearly, like, a bizarre recreation of the events of the original Star Wars trilogy, episodes 4 through 6. Whereas Twilight of the Republic is definitely after. It's definitely, like, Clone Wars era. It's, like, after episode 2. It's, like, between episode 2 and episode 3. Because when they reference Geonosis, they're like, we've already been here. How do I get up there? So I'm kind of digging Rise more than the other ones. Okay, I need... Let's get Vader on here. I need that force jump. Gotta get up there. What's up, Vader? Can you get up there? No! Oh, no. Oh, maybe we gotta go around. Use a glider for one of the top of the trees. Thank you, MaxiGeek. MaxiGeek, your power disk is incoming, man. Thank you for your patience. Use the glider from one of the... Okay, maybe I gotta go up. Gotta go up here, maybe? I like glider talk, man. I like the way that sounds. The Ewoks got those hip gliders. Over here. We're just exploring, you know? If the glider thing's up here, great. If not, you know, no harm, no foul. I don't think it is. It's kind of fun heading up here, though. Maybe it's over there. Oh, that might look like it. Let's see if I can hit this. Yeah! 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 Yes! Yes! Excellent. It's like Just Cause up in here. Nice. Like, can we just appreciate this for a second? Oh, it's gone. Exactly for a second. Wait, hold on. Hold on. Okay, there we go. I gotta stop the Minock menace. Vader is a really nice guy, you know? I mean, you know, I think at heart, you know, he really wants to do the right thing. He's just really into the dark side, you know? Good evening from Finland, everyone. Nice. Speediest from Finland. Don't go up. Aw. Too bad they don't have a battle-damaged Vader from Force Unleashed. That would make a sweet costume. Yeah, it'd be fun to have a power disc where you can, like, take his helmet off, and it's, like, old Anakin Vader with, like, the scars and everything. Nice. Okay, Vader. Take a seat. Have we unlocked Yoda yet? I think we did. Yeah. And is Yoda one of those, like, one-point characters that I have? Yeah, one point. Ugh. I gotta reset the stats. Because that drives me crazy, the arrows in the top, up in the upper left next to their name. They're like, you've yet to level up your character. It's like, I can't. The game should know that. The Skull Ones are attacking. Many of the two-legged, not-living beasts surround the village. You must help us, or all's lost. Destroy the Skull Ones. Save Red Tree Village! I think Yoda's a very good character to do this. Yes. Yoda is prepared. Stay airborne, Yoda. Finisher opportunity there, and I messed up. Jump, get in the air, get in the air! Oh, okay. Let's get Luke back. Keep messing up the finishers. I don't think I've really spent a lot of time with those. So I'm not really great at them. Nice. Get over here. Aw. Time to get Han back. Where'd Han go? Han? Oh, there he is. Make short work of this guy. Nice. These AT-STs are way easier to kill than the AT-ST in Shadows of the Empire, if you guys have ever played that. Those AT-STs have lots of health. Oh, interesting that you can't, like, finish them off when they're in their little damage state. I guess that's convenient so that, like, you know, kids, if they're playing the game, don't accidentally take them out in the process of, like, trying to get in them. I guess that makes sense. Do you guys think there's a possibility for more Bloodborne DLC? They have said specifically no. There will not be more Bloodborne DLC, so... they might change their mind next year, but... The Bloodborne DLC is so specifically geared towards... Like, Bloodborne. You know, it's not just kind of like, oh, and then this... Then, you know, you do this random thing. Love the Wilhelm scream. He seems better than Battlefront Han. He certainly sounds better. Actually, the Han in Battlefront isn't bad. But, where's this guy going? If he's got, like a run. I guess the AT-STs don't run. This is max AT-ST speed. Brandon, for which Star Wars game would you like to have a sequel or to be remade, remastered? I would love to have another Jedi Knight game. That is my absolute number one Star Wars game that they need to make. Oh, okay. Oh, did that guy just walk into a trap? Okay. Hilarious. The Force Unleashed was supposed to be this, like, the promise of this great, you know, Jedi game, but we played as this character that, like, I didn't know, and, like, it was kind of interesting. Actually, the first Force Unleashed game had an interesting story. They kind of, like, talk about how... Nice. Clever. Okay, there you go. They kind of talked about how the Rebel Alliance was formed, even though they, you know, that was just, the developers of that game kind of making up their own weird story. But I really want a Jedi game. I want a game where I can play as Dooku or Yoda or Obi-Wan or Luke or Mace Windu or the Emperor or, you know, anybody that's ever wielded, or Ki-Adi-Mundi, or, like, anyone who's ever wielded a lightsaber. I want a multiplayer mode where we can play as them. And I think, I want to say Obi-Wan for the Xbox. I think it was exclusive to the Xbox, and it was just called Obi-Wan. Has a multiplayer mode that takes place in the Jedi Tower that's just... It's like a battle royale with all... Every Jedi. Like, every Jedi in the prequel era going at each other. It was really cool. And I'm surprised that that is, like, one of the only... If not one of the only games to ever do that. There are also some really... Oh, what's up? What's up, Lando? There are also some really spectacular mods to the Jedi Knight series on PC. I can't remember the name of it, but there's this one mod... That just went nuts, that, like, recreated, like, every lightsaber fight, all sorts of, like, eras and environments, so... I would love that. Remake the new Star Wars Battlefront. Hey-o! No, just make more maps. I do not want a new Masters of Terras Kasi, although a Star Wars fighting game would be fun. If they did it right. I actually wouldn't mind, like, a cool, like, 16-bit, kind of pixelated Star Wars fighting game. Like old-school King of Fighters style, would be cool. Darth Maul game was supposed to happen, yeah. But we'll see. There's all sorts of crazy Star Wars rumors. We'll see which... Movie Battles! Thank you! Movie Battles! That's what it's called. If you guys... Google Jedi Knight Movie Battles. Even the trailers for that mod were really good. Yeah, that team went pretty crazy with those things. Remake Pod Racer. Pod Racer's pretty good on its own. never know when, like, Adam Boyes is kind of like gonna come out on stage and say, "Ladies and gentlemen, Amy Hennig." Like, yeah. But we'll see. Like, maybe they're just waiting for episode 7 to come out, you know, so like people get hyped for get all that movie hype out of the way. Maybe just don't like. Maybe just don't give us like too much Star Wars stuff. I know it seems like how could you ever possibly do that too much Star Wars. Maybe they got so much stuff coming. Cause we got like a teaser for Rogue One, but we haven't really seen it. We've seen like pictures, but they haven't released that second trailer yet. So I wonder if they really just want to take all of the Star Wars hype and just focus it squarely on. Nice, yeah. Let's get in there and blow stuff up. And just really focus it on Episode 7. Really, just make sure like let's just have this movie make as much money as it possibly can. Love this. So great. Okay. Focus, Luke. Let's get in there. Love it. Or did I just beat these up? Nice. Wow, that was much easier than in the film. There's going to be this new Star Wars movie every year. It's going to be hard to avoid too much Star Wars stuff from now on. This is true. Uh-oh, Luke. Big confrontation coming up, everybody. I want DLC from the new movie for Battlefront. Well, you got it. I mean, the Battle of Jakku has come out. And, you know, since we know about Jakku, since we can imagine, like, what's happening in that battle, I think, oh, yeah. Yeah, Infinity Akbar. Yeah, Maxi Geek, a lot of people have been asking that, like, who should play young Han Solo? I have no idea. I'm actually kind of... I don't know. We're in this, like, new era of Star Wars. Like, I really want new characters. Like, I'm actually not that excited. I don't care what Han Solo was doing as a kid. I really don't. Like, I like to think that Han Solo's life, like, really wasn't that exciting until he got involved in the Rebel Alliance. Like, he was just a smuggler, you know? Okay, I gotta focus. This is a very pivotal battle for the Rebel Alliance. Hold on.
We've got Star Destroyers launching waves of fighters. We need to hit both. Thing we can be in two places.
I should play. I'm too old to play Han Solo. I'm older than Harrison Ford was in the original film, so that wouldn't work. But I appreciate the sentiment. Like, the number of games that let you do what I'm doing right now is surprisingly small. There are not a ton of games that focus on the Battle of Endor. I'm doing it, Akbar. I'm going as fast as I can. Nice. I wish there was a Lando figure. I would put the Lando figure on right now, because technically Luke Skywalker's flying the Millennium Falcon right now. Whoop. Oh, wait. No, no.
Another wave inbound to the medical frigate.
Okay, those guys are not currently attacking the medical frigate. Does the medical frigate have health, or do I just like need to stay around here? It doesn't look like it does. Can I blow these up? Oh, that's so great. Yeah. Not sure what that did, but feels good. You gotta wonder what the actual functionality of the medical frigate is. It's not like you can heal ships or something. I guess, like, they want to get these, like, medical officers down to the planet so that they can help soldiers. I'm guessing that is the urgency. Because Wedge actually says that in the Battle of Endor. He says they're headed towards the medical frigate. I thought that was the medical frigate, actually. I guess not. Because that's where Han and, when I say that, I mean this guy right here. This is the ship that Han, Luke and Leia and R2 and C-3PO are at the end of Empire Strikes Back when it, like, pans away from their ship. And that's, like, where Luke gets his new hand. So I thought that was the medical frigate, but I'm mistaken. We're learning all sorts of new things about Star Wars this year, everybody. Oh, what's going on here?
That last wave of ties is making for the medical frigate.
Why is the objective back there? Oh, nice. I can blow up the engines? Oh, nice.
Halfway there. Keep doing what you're doing, Gold Leader.
You got it.
Shields are down. I'm reading the reactor in critical.
Yeah.
Hit it again.
Now.
Redemption to all ships, please assist. Our shields are almost gone.
I'm gonna take out this thing. Yeah. Although technically that wouldn't happen in space, but that's okay. Cause, like, why is it falling? You know what I mean? Like, unless you're, like, near a planet getting pulled into its orbit, like, why would you fall? Which is kind of unfortunate. I mean, basically what would happen is you would, like, the reason that would work. Uh-oh. Did I just fail? Oh, well, lost a ship. What are you gonna do? Oh, my God. Okay, I guess I gotta take out both these guys. All right. Health is low.
The Admiral is gone. All groups, all ships break off. I repeat.
Uh-oh. Oh, I failed you guys. I'm sorry.
It's over. We've lost.
But I just took out another Star Destroyer.
Gold Leader, this is Red Leader. Welcome to the fight.
Okay.
Late as usual. I'm going to go after the Admiral's flagship, Home One, and the medical frigate Redemption.
Oh, there it is. Yeah, medical frigate. Okay.
We've got Star Destroyers launching waves of fighters.
Need to hit both. Okay, so I was wasting precious time fighting the TIE fighters. I do have to tap the attack button. I cannot hold it down. Uh-oh.
The TIEs are attacking the flagship.
If I hold it down once I do that, I get like four fires. Yeah, you gotta keep tapping. I won't. Tap.
Keep doing what you're doing, Gold Leader. They're launching escape pods. Shields are gone entirely. The Star Destroyer is almost down. One more run.
Whoa, look out. Nothing. Didn't mean to just fly right into that Star Destroyer. Finish off the remaining TIE fighters. You got it. Oh no! thank goodness I didn't have to do that over again. It's a kid's game. Yay! Oh, that was convenient. I don't see any X-Wings flying around. That's a little weird. It's just me. Get over here, you remaining TIE Fighter. Oh, there's a game that should be remade, TIE Fighter. X-Wing's great too, but TIE Fighter's so good. Like, top 100 games of all time good. Get away from my ship. I'm ignoring chat, sorry, I'm trying to finish this up. Nice.
And you, Red Leader. Our capital ship survived. We have a real chance to win this.
Thanks, Red Leader. All wings form up. We're taking this fight to the Death Star.
Princess Leia, I must advise against this action. It's far too dangerous.
Your concern is duly noted, Admiral.
Brandon, will we see some crossovers with Kinda Funny in the future? Maybe invite some into GT Live or something. Those guys are great. Kinda Funny is awesome. Kinda Funny loves us, actually. I've been talking to Tim Geddes about that. I actually went over to... I would go for a greasing palms emote. Yeah, that'd be nice. Maybe just like... here we go. Yeah, we will make that happen. Trouble is, you know, we're in Los Angeles. They're in San Francisco. And so it's tough... It's not like when they come into Los Angeles, they're gonna, like, you know, let us know, like, hey, we're coming into LA. I mean, that would be nice, but, so it's just a matter of, you know, bugging them, and really trying to figure that stuff out, and I don't think it's gonna happen before the holidays, but, in the new year, I'm gonna reach out to Greg or Tim, and, try to make that happen. I think the easiest thing to do would be for us to just plan a trip to San Francisco, and just get up there and try to get on their show. I know they want Kyle Bossman to be on their, oh, here we go. No, well, yeah, okay. Definitely gotta be Luke. This is it. I think we're gonna end the playset right now. What time is it? Okay, it's 11:30, but we gotta end the playset. Oh, man. You guys. Okay. Alright. Now, I ain't gonna cheese this. Come on. Let's get in there. If I can beat the first boss in the old Hunters, I can beat Darth Vader. Oh, I keep messing up my finisher. Health. Okay.
There is no escape.
Ouch. Get Luke. Come on, Luke.
Underestimate me.
Oh no.
Give in to your hate.
Messed up the finisher again. Uh-oh. Oh, here we go. Oh no. No, don't do that, Vader. Thank you, Sawubi. I'm guessing that's Sawubi, maybe Sawubble. Yeah, his finisher doesn't work on Vader. Whoa. Oh no! Oh no! Pick it up! Pick it up! Yeah! That'd be hilarious if you did that in the movie. if Luke's like, never! And then just like grabs like a explosive thing and chucks it at Vader.
Defenses are useless against the dark side.
Oh no, oh no. Bring in Anakin, break the game. I don't know if I can... I don't know if Anakin's unlocked yet. I wonder. I mean, I can bring in Vader, too. Oh, he's not unlocked. I can bring in Vader, though. Let's have Vader fight himself. Yeah! Good call. And I remember, like, when Infinity first launched, this really confused people. They're just like, why can a bad guy fight a bad guy? It's like, how awesome is this? I don't think there is a video game in existence where Vader can have a lightsaber battle with Vader. I think this is it. I think you're looking at it right here. This is an extremely epic boss fight. Oh no, Vader's choking Vader! Okay, let me get some health. Actually, no, I probably don't need it. Nope. Oh, we're actually playing some prequel music here. Yeah! There it is! Vader whooped his own butt. So jealous that I just seen as Kylo Ren. Yes, yes, yes. She's a very nice person, but that was extremely unfair. And I bet she doesn't have a single clue how valuable it is. Didn't you hear, Brandon? Episode 7 is going to be a romantic comedy starring Ben Stiller. I hadn't heard that. That would be very surprising. Okay, we got focus here. Hold on. That's an easy way to remove them from this scene. Get him, Vader. Get him, Vader. Oh, it was a bummer we didn't see the Emperor falling. I knew you had good in you. You were right about me. You were right. I wonder if Vader was damaged by the lightning. You know? I wonder if... Because you can see his, like, skull, like, appear when he gets electrocuted. So I wonder if, like, that was... Obviously, Luke messed him up, but I wonder if that was, like, kind of the killing blow. I wonder if that's what really took him out. Let's get Luke back on there. In the interim. Final mission time. Oh, are we going in? Oh, we're going in. Okay, we're extending Toybox Tuesday a little bit, but we're wrapping this up. This is big. Oh man, let's do it. Oh, I'm so pumped. Oh man. Oh no. They love it when the ship blows up and you gotta fly through the ship. Avalanche is very into that this year. Oh no! Too focused on the things I was shooting. Uh-oh. Whoa. Well, that's how you do that, okay. Whoa, whoa. Oh no. That was the moment where the satellite dish gets knocked off the top of the Falcon. Whoa. Whoa, whoa. Whoa. Oh man, this is sweet. This is pretty cool. I mean, this whole game is really fun, but like, this is, that was some epic stuff right there. Yoink.
I can't shake him.
Whoa, whoa. I'm working on it. Oh, sorry. It was weird to, like, not save that guy and have it say good, like, immediately. Oh, no. No. Move. Oh, no. Am I glitching out? Oh, no! Let's see if I can evade, if that'll fix it. There we go. Whoa. Uh-oh. Well. Here we go.
There it is. That's the main reactor.
That's one way to do it. I didn't know the Falcon could strafe, but she's a hell of a ship, you never know. Nailed it. Whoa! Getting all anime up in here. Alright, let's get out of here. Whoa. Whoa. And there's still some stuff I have yet to do in this playset. Like, there's, like, races and fun things you can do on the various planets. There's missions you can do in space on the different planets, so there's more stuff. Maybe we'll just kind of goof around in the playset next week before Episode 7 comes out. Oh, man. Whoa. Oh no, not that way. Yikes. This is not Force Awakens, Ronaldo, don't worry. The Falcon is a she. That is true. I could have done that better. Yeah, my dodge was not on point. Oh, yay, we're celebrating on all the planets. Yay! No! It's the special edition version, no. They're like, well, we got the figure, so. Those Ewoks love Han. Explore, discover new missions, replay some of your favorite moments. Cool, yeah, so there's new stuff to do at all the planets. We have not picked the game of the year yet, so we shall see. I think everyone's pretty exhausted today. We might pick another countdown, today. Are you just gonna drop me into space? Wait, what are we doing? What's happening right now? Is this just what space is like outside of Endor? This is kind of weird. It's like, didn't we just win this fight? Well, I'm gonna have to blow up those Star Destroyers. Okay, that is it for Toybox Tuesday. Somebody's coming in. Brad Alice coming in. Just finished Rise of the Empire. Just blew up Death Star 2.
Oh, hell yeah.
Rebel Alliance, victorious. Vader destroyed Vader.
So canon.
I Vader fight Vader. Super canon. Cygnus, yeah, you can add me on PSN. Just make sure you leave a note. I generally don't accept friend requests if somebody just sends me one. But if you send one and say, hey, I'm Cygnus from, you know, chat. You know, I'm a big fan of GT. Then, like, I will definitely friend you.
Can you tell them about your PowerDisc story at PSX?
Oh, yeah. So at PSX, Brad was there to witness this. I brought a couple of the King Mickey power discs, and I tweeted out, I'm like, I'm at the Disney Infinity booth. If you come, if you show up, I'll give you a King Mickey power disc. Nobody showed up.
No one.
Three people from the staff of Disney Infinity and the official Disney Infinity Twitter account retweeted my tweet, and no one came by. I didn't even get a message from people that were like, whoa, I'm upstairs. I'm at the Capcom Cup. Like, hold on. Like, I'm on my way. Just stay there, and I'll head on over. Or like, hey, I'm not even into Infinity. I'm just going to resell it on eBay. Zero interest. Which I think, you know, doesn't necessarily mean no interest in Infinity. It's just, I think the PSX crowd, you know, so many months after the launch of Infinity, that's not really what people were there for. But Infinity had a great setup. They had all the figures there. They were showing off all the playsets. The Maxi Geek, 17 hours it would have taken me to get there. So it depends. You know, obviously if you go to if I went to D23 and I had done that, I would have died. I would have literally...
Yeah, they would have swarmed.
I would have been mobbed. It would have been Dark Souls. I would have literally just been completely overwhelmed. I did not say I was from GT Chat when I tried friending Brandon Jones. Well, do it again. Send me another one. Cancel that friend request. Send another one. In all caps, be like, you fool, add me, you jerk face. So there it is. Toybox Tuesday. We'll be back again next week, focusing probably more on, you know, episodes 4, 5, and 6, because episode 7 is coming out next. Technically, it comes out next Friday, but I'm going to be seeing it Thursday night. I got tickets, 9 a.m. showing. Pumped. I'm going to be seeing it with my friends. GT Live tomorrow night. I don't know, actually, off the top of my head what we're streaming tonight. It's on the schedule. You can check out below. But tomorrow night is going to be a fun GT Live for me. It might not be, like, the best sell as far as, like, super celebrities are concerned. But we're going to have a guy named Marco Rosato. You fool, add me, you jerk face. Yes, in quotes. Marco Rosato cut and did the graphics for the two chapters that we did release of the Warcraft retrospective. I think we did at least two, maybe three. He also did graphics for Kingdom Hearts timeline. He did the graphics and cut the Legend of Zelda timeline. And did a lot of graphics work for us when he was at GameTrailers. When we made the move over to Defy, Marco decided to become his own boss, and he created an animation company called Mode Select that has done all sorts of stuff. They did stuff for the Game Awards recently. I just think that would be interesting for you guys to talk to Marco, not only about the stuff that he's done in GameTrailers, but what it was like moving out of production in games journalism and moving into production in the actual video game industry for games and for gaming events. So he will be on tomorrow. It'll be at least Marco Rosato. He might also bring a really nice guy named Dan Rackison, who also was in Marco's Bay when we were back at Viacom and produced a lot of stuff for GT. So Mode Select will be our guest tomorrow on GT Live. The countdown for this week, I'm really excited about. This was an idea from Mr. Michael P. Huber. It is the top 10 characters of 2015. The top 10 video game characters of 2015. So, meaning new characters. So, you know, as much as I would want to put Joker on there. So the top 10 new characters that we were introduced to in video games in 2015. It was an interesting list, interesting picks, interesting to look back. We did it while we were in the process of our GOTY deliberations, so it was kind of fun to talk about the characters that we really associated with this year that we appreciated and to honor some of the, you know. We do not have best performance in our Game of the Year awards, unlike the Game Awards, which does. And so it'll be nice to talk about, you know, our favorite characters of the year. So look for that this Friday. Tune into GT Live tomorrow. We will be back at 6 p.m. Pacific time tonight, playing something. I think it's, something comes out. I think it's Earth Defense Force we're playing tomorrow. Yakuza. I think we're Yakuza 5. I think we are streaming tonight. So in Earth Defense Force, we're going to be playing tomorrow. There were many new characters. There were more than 10. We definitely have a number 11 prep for tomorrow, but I think there were at least like 4 or 5 others that were introduced. Like D-Dog is a good example. It was like, D-Dog's so good, but he's just a dog, you know? there's not a lot of depth to D-Dog. Like D-Dog's a puppy, and then he's a dog, and he kills people and tags targets. But it's, you know, it's like, it was tough We'll talk about this tomorrow as well, but like it was, we didn't want to focus on functionality. Like there's some characters that are great in the game, but we really want to focus on like good personalities, characters that are really focused on and influence the story very well, and just characters that just had fascinating relationships. Hopefully you guys will dig that this Friday. We will see you tonight with Yakuza 5 with Mr. Michael Huber, who has already started the game. I'm curious what he's going to spend time doing tonight, knowing that Huber can get kind of distracted when he plays open world games. 2015, Year of Dogs, Fallout 4, MGS5, Mad Max. Also Year of the Hot Woman with a Bow. Like, we got Tomb Raider, we got Call of Duty had a hooded woman with a bow. We just finally saw the gameplay trailer for Paragon, which, speaking of, I want to do a trailer score for today. She had a bow. So, yeah, women with bows. Hot this year. Lots of fun stuff coming up this week. If I do not see you next week for Toybox Tuesday, have a wonderful holiday. I think that's probably going to be the last Toybox Tuesday of the year next week. Then we will start the new year with new projects and new fun stuff to build. If you guys are a fan of building stuff, I saw Dreams at Dreams the game, not Dreams the thing that happens when you sleep, but the next game for Media Molecule is really incredible. I'm going to be streaming that a lot. I'm not going to let that take over Toybox Tuesday, but I'm definitely going to be spending a lot of time with Dreams, definitely building stuff, definitely want to work with Don on Don's design lab and really show you guys the cool stuff that you can do in Dreams. I'm really excited for when that game comes out. So if you guys missed it, check out Media Molecule on Twitch. They've been doing a ton of streams, so you can check out just really like the crazy stuff that you can do in that game. And hopefully we'll get back to building stuff soon. I love you guys. May the Force be with you. Have a wonderful week. Brrrr.